go to the cafes for coffee all the time, and it's quiet, peaceful, and this is just horrible.
People were not sure what's happening, what to do.
A community left shaken by a brazen murder in the Melbourne suburb of Keilor.
Some guys with balaclavas got out of the car and shot the people sitting at the table. And then got in the car and took off up the road.
CCTV captured the moment two men shot and killed notorious gangland figure Gavin Capable Preston on Saturday morning.
Two male offenders dressed in black, driving a black Audi SUV, were involved in the incident, which was found dumped by them shortly thereafter.
Preston was having breakfast with a bus AJ Magni, the son of late crime boss Nabil Magni, when the men opened fire.
Given the circumstances, we believe it's linked to organised crime.
Preston's reputation for violence preceded him, a notorious name in the criminal underworld for three decades.
I can reassure the public that we believe that this was a targeted attack and that the offenders were there to shoot the two males that had been shot.
Preston died at the scene. Magni remains in hospital with serious injuries. It comes just weeks after a series of shootings in Sydney amid an escalating gang war which saw five people shot in as many days.
We will not tolerate this level of violence, particularly by a very small number of criminals who want to play out their tit-for-tat in our streets.
So, as more blood spills on suburban streets, is Australia being plunged into a new era of underworld violence?
Well, Mark Lauchs is an expert on gangs and organised crime. He's with us now. Mark, do you think we're entering a new era of this kind of violence?
We are already in an era of gangland violence. It's just spreading really out of Sydney into parts of the country. Sydney's had a lot more of this sort of activity than other major capital cities, and I think Melbourne second, and then we'll probably see Brisbane follow on quickly after that. And it's connected mostly to the rise in the drug trade and the money that's associated with that.
It's quite shocking that many of these attacks are happening in broad daylight, in public. Why aren't they worried about being caught?
That's a really good question. A lot of them are getting caught, especially in Sydney. It's not a very effective method of doing it, and I think it's got a lot to do with how much money people are willing to spend to get the job done properly. And they're doing it on the cheap and they're getting what they're paid for, and this is not a very professional activity that we can see on the video in relation to this particular shooting.
How are they doing it on the cheap?
Well, you know, if you were to read the old school crooks like, you know, Chopper Reed and people like that, if you wanted to eliminate a person, we would just not hear about them anymore. There wouldn't be even evidence that they were killed. You know, we can go back to Christopher Flannery and people like that. We still don't know how he was killed. That's how the professionals do it. And we're not dealing with that level of professionalism at all.
Let's talk about Gavin Preston. How feared was he in Melbourne?
He had a very big reputation, and the general consensus is that people were afraid of him. Now, whether that was because he was particularly effective as a violent crook or whether that's because he was unpredictable, you know, his nickname was Capable, but we don't know whether that was an ironic nickname as well. He may just have been a very unpredictable, violent person.
Do all of these killings happening in public concurrently indicate that maybe the police are losing control of safety in the community at the moment?
It's very hard for the police to prevent this sort of violence, police anywhere in the world. This isn't something that they can put plans in place to stop random killings. Well, not random from the point of view of the killers, but from our perspective, what look like random killings. If you don't know what's going to happen and you don't know that a plot has already been hatched, then it's hard to prevent it. In some of the cases in Sydney,
Mark,
the police did know.
There's a brazenness to all of this, isn't there? Doesn't that say to us that maybe the police aren't quite in control?
I don't know that anyone could be in control of this. In one case in Sydney, the police were aware there was a contract on a particular man's life. They told him, and he, being brazen as well, decided that he didn't care. He wasn't going to go into hiding. In fact, you could probably find half a dozen men in Sydney in the last 10 years have done exactly that, where they've had warnings. The police have said, we know something's going to happen, we don't know when. But the men, being real men from that criminal fraternity, couldn't be seen to back down, so they stayed out there to show that they were brave, to show that they were going to stand up to anything. But unfortunately, that just makes you a bigger target.
Mark Lauchs, thanks for your time tonight.
No problem.